Welcome to Thermo Wick Thursday. My husband and daughter brought me back heaps of rocket in the weekend from the beach. And so I thought, I wonder if there is a rocket pesto recipe in Kokodoo. Sure enough, I Googled rocket pesto and there it was. I love that on Kokodoo, which is the online cookbook with your Thermomix, there is basically everything and anything that you want to make. I did a demo on the weekend and one of the ladies who bought one, she said, can I make steamed buns? And I was like, pork steamed buns, absolutely. She said, what about gnocchi? And I'm like, absolutely. So I am making pesto with rocket and chili today. I've got my sparkling back machine here. So this is a limited edition. It was actually meant to finish today, but it's actually been extended until the start of September. So if you're thinking about getting the black, reach out. It is such a gorgeous machine. I think it's got a nice little, it's just a little bit of a texture on here, but it's really, really cool. And so as I say, that's on, and it's still got the free glider board and the $140 mix shop voucher. So it's really, really worth the investment if you like a black. It's also available on the white. Anyway, so rocket pesto with rocket and chili. So let's get started. I'm just making a half batch because even though they brought me heaps, it still needed 120 grams and I didn't have that much. So I'm just making a half batch. Love that you can just mix things up. Okay, so we're just going to start cooking. And it was asking me to weigh the oil. I thought I'd just skip that step. I've already weighed it. Okay. So weighing the oil, remove the jug. So because I'm doing a half batch, I'm adding my garlic, just my garlic, into here. And I'm just going to insert the measuring cup next. And I'm just grating that garlic. So it will grate one clove of garlic the way that the, and see that was like 2 seconds. And I'll show you what that looks like. See, it's tiny. It's one garlic clove, but it still does it. Food processor just doesn't. It's because it's got low blades and high blades. So it cuts everything that comes into contact with it. Next, scrape down the sides with the spatula, which it comes with this special spatula, which is fantastic. So now I'm adding my rocket leaves in. It's weighing, okay? So I'm on zero. I'm just putting in 60 grams because that's all. And so that's about just over 60 grams. Next, my Parmesan cheese. I've just got that in chunks. I don't need to grate it. So if you buy grated cheese, a grated Parmesan, you actually just do your own. You save your money there. So I've only got 40 grams of Parmesan. I've got some hazelnuts. Now, if I didn't have hazelnuts in the cupboard, I just would have used sunflower seeds because they're much cheaper. And they give the same effect. I just happen to have hazelnuts. I'm just going to add a couple more of those because I like hazelnut. Chili. This is a mighty but small chili. Add that in. Some salt. Half a teaspoon of salt. Now, I really like cheesy flavour, so I'm adding in some nutritional yeast flakes because that just really intensifies the flavour, because that's what I do with my normal pesto. You can modify the recipes as you know or as you want to, which is wonderful. Okay, so now we're inserting the measuring cup in the lid. And we're going 8 seconds at speed 8. So speed 8 is, you know, really fast. We are milling, we are grinding. Okay, so we're turning around. You can hear that it's, you know, that it's done the job. So let me show you that. Look at that. That was 8 seconds. Sorry, it's very close. That was 8 seconds. And that is just smelling so beautiful. It's still got like a bit of a crunch with the hazelnuts. Okay, next. scraped down the sides, done that. Now this is very cool. Actually, I think we might need to do this. We're just doing that again. 5 seconds. Thanks for joining me. Okay, so we hit the next button. Now, with measuring cups still in place, this is what I love. Okay, we are keeping the measuring cup, but you know how if you're making mayonnaise, you need to drizzle your oil in slowly. This is not tight. Okay, so it allows you to drizzle your oil into here and drizzle it into your into the Thermomix. So we're going at speed 4, and we're going for 2 minutes. So I'm just pouring this in around the top, and I know that I've got the right amount of oil in there. And I'm just lifting up that lid. And it's just slowly drizzling the oil into it at that right consistency so that it's not all going in at once. Does that make sense? So now that's just going to keep on drizzling down in there while it's just doing it mixing. It's mixing and it's getting it fine and it's evenly blending it. I can't achieve that in my food processor. And so while that's happening, I wanted to take the opportunity to talk to you about my 5-day challenge, which is happening next week. If you are interested in healthy habits, creating healthier habits, and winter has really taken its toll, then I would love to invite you to join me on my Revive and Thrive 5-day healthy eating habit reboot. And we're going to be talking about just how to instill simple, easy, achievable, and sustainable healthy habits. Now, if you want to find out more information about it, head to wickedwellbeing.com/habits. I will post the link in the comments box below. But it's all about, you know, we're going to look at 3 daily habits being lemon and water, getting to bed earlier, and having a nutritional breakfast or first meal of the day. So that's still going. We've only got 20 seconds left, and then I'll be able to show you what that looks like. And it's just, we're talking about how to do healthy eating on a budget, how to do it when you're time poor and exhausted, sustainable snacking, and how to do it for the long term. So I just really want to set you up, because I know that winter has been so dreary and spring is on its way, which is really, really exciting. Okay, let's hit next. This looks phenomenal. Look at that. That is just so gorgeous. So just by adding in that slow drizzle, and that's achieved the texture. Now I will just transfer that into a container and have it in the fridge. Now let me show you what I made this morning. I made butter. This is just because it was a trial, but I had a little bit of cream left over, and cream just tends to... just to go off, because we use a little bit, and then, so I made it into butter. It took me 5 minutes. So there is so many cost savings with having a Thermomix. Reach out if you've got any questions, and if you want to join me on that challenge, then head to wickedwellbeing.com/habits. I'll put the link in the comments box below. Thanks for joining me. See ya.